So here you have Zephyr running on the ARM Cortex M33 class processor, right?
That's right. This is a demonstration of trusted firmware for M-class devices. We took on ourselves to integrate Zephyr with trust firmware. And we started this work on Monday when we actually reached here.
You started on Monday?
Yes.
And right here, we're looking at a special kind of configuration right here. There is an ARM Cortex M33 in there.
So yeah, this is a MPS2 FPGA board where you can program Cortex. This is basically a programming board where you can put all the V8 M-based systems or any Cortex M system.
So there's an FPGA?
And it has an FPGA. This is, if you look at the board on this side, this is running a Castor subsystem. This is a Castor subsystem, which is essentially based on CM33 with a lot of security IPs integrated with this. And this provides hardware level isolation, so you might have heard about the trust zone, ARM trust zone on for V8M. This is a this hardware supports all the V8M trust zone related IPs. And this demonstration showcases the integration of trusted firmware M project with Zephyr, where Zephyr is actually running on the non-secure side. The trusted firmware is the essentially trusted firmware running on the secure side. If you look at the demo, this is showing interaction between It's showing interaction between non-secure world and secure world. On the non-secure world, Zephyr is running as the, well, your RTOS is running the scheduler, is running some other tickers. And in one of the tasks, is essentially making calls to the secure world and is storing certain objects, then reading it back and comparing if it is the same or not. So it's showing the whole path from non-secure world to going to the secure world and coming back. And at the same time, making sure that all the parties, which is secure as well as non-secure, they're happy with the whole setup. So it's essentially showcasing that the non-secure world RTOS can happily integrate with the TFM without much of a problem. And the fact that we started only on last Monday is kind of proof that it's a step in the right direction. It all makes sense. It took less than 2 days to integrate a new, completely new RTOS, which did not have any security, well, trust zone awareness in the past. And we did not have to make a single line change in the trusted firmware M. I think it's another proof that it's headed in the right direction.
So and is there a real Cortex M33 or is it emulated on FPGA?
Oh, it is emulated on FPGA, but it's actual RTL. It's not a simulation or a simulation.
It's the actual design of the M33.
It's actual design of CM33.
In just 5 days, you were able to modify Zephyr to support it?
I would say less than 2 days, because the actual time spent was much less than 5 days. We got it running yesterday morning, but in between we had a lot of sessions, a lot of other discussions. So the actual effective time spent on doing this demo is probably less than 2 days.
And this is the ultimate secure IoT platform for the future.
This is ARM's reference platform for showcasing how a IoT system should be done with the ARM's IPs.
With the hardware security.
With hardware security, which is ARM Trust Zone. And it provides hardware level isolation between the secure and non-secure domains. And this demo is essentially showcasing that separation and showing that it's the software that we have designed for secure world is compatible with the already existing non-secure schedulers, non-secure operating systems.
So this is going to be 100% secure. What do you think?
I think that's the step in the right direction. As I said, the trusted firmware project, we just made our first release in December last year. So it still has a lot of miles to cover, but it's a step in the right direction. And at this point, we would like collaboration and basically feedback from all the involved people, all the people who are doing IoT security or security in general. I would like to invite them and start looking at the implementation and start giving us feedback, start getting involved in the trustedfirmware.org project, which is now an open governance project.
And this is the M33 chipset and the N23 are coming very soon. There's so, like Nordic Semiconductor announced one, and other company also, NXP maybe.
I may not be able to comment on the chipsets coming from other partners, but from Arm, the Castor and the Musca solutions are the one which has basically Cortex M33 based. M23 based, I think there are solutions coming up, but I may not be able to talk about the partner specific details.